Celtic Cast On podcast. My name is Kelly, and you can find me everywhere as Celtic Cast On. I am coming to you from the beautiful east coast of Canada, where it is slightly snowing right now. I'm just watching out the window, and the flakes are just starting to fall. We've had quite an odd winter so far for snow, at least where I am in the province. We get a snowstorm, but then we get rain immediately after, if not during. So we have literally had a green Christmas, a green January, which is very odd. Normally we have tons of snow. We haven't been able to play out in it much. We went snowshoeing once, and that was just because we were out we're on a land hunt right now, so we're out looking for land, and that was kind of deeper into the country, and that's usually where more of the snow is. So, yeah, it's kind of lacking in outdoor fun right now. I did get to go skating yesterday. We have some indoor rinks, but we have some beautiful outdoor rinks as well. And if I had a choice, I'd definitely go for the outdoor rink. And yesterday I decided to take the kids in the afternoon, just before the elementary schools were out, but the high schools weren't, so I knew a lot of kids wouldn't be there yet. It was Friday, and the parents would still be at work normally. So we were the only ones at the rink. It was awesome. We got it all to ourselves. We could skate around and have fun. Instead of having to skate in one continuous circle over and over, we got to move around and have some fun. But anyway, so let's just jump right in and talk about some FOs. Oh, that I have is actually what I'm wearing. This is Sun Daughter by Diana Walla, and I had started this, I think I had two sleeves done the last time I podcast. This just flew. It was the only thing I was working on, and it was such an enjoyable process. Let me just talk about how it's constructed. So it's worked from the bottom up. You work the sleeves bottom up, and then you join it all in the round to do the yoke. Now, the brilliant thing about this pattern is that the sleeves it tells you to knit the sleeves first. This is an amazing breakthrough for me, I think, because I'm always on sleeve island. So when I get the body done, I have sleeve to knit, and then I have another sleeve to knit. By the time I'm on the second sleeve, I'm kind of worn out and ready to move on to something else. But knitting the sleeves first is an amazing idea. I'm excited. When I knit the first sleeve, I get onto the second sleeve and I'm like, yeah, I'm almost to the body. And then when I start the body, I'm like, yeah, I'm almost to the yoke. So I was excited through the whole thing. It flew off the needles, and I think this is the way I'm going to be knitting my bottom-up sweaters from now on. That being said, this is also the first round yoke sweater that I've ever knit. And I'm in love. We'll talk about that later, but I did cast on another sweater bottom-up with a yoke. So this is knit with Classic Elite Sky Tweed. It is discontinued and has been for many years, but I'll show you the little flex that it has. How gorgeous is that? I've actually been on the lookout for more of this yarn. It's an Aran weight, and it works up beautifully. It softens beautifully, and I need more of it. So I've been checking on Ravelry on their D-Stash page to see if someone else has some that they're looking to get rid of. There is a pinky colored one, but I'm kind of looking for maybe a brown or a green, a blue, a gray. So if you have some Sky Tweed that you're looking to get rid of, message me and I may be interested. So I had talked about this yarn actually before, that I had knit it into several sweaters. The last cardigan that I had knit it with was on a small gauge, and it had coin cables all over it. And it was very stiff. It literally could have stood up itself. So the stockinette was a great match for this yarn, and it did allow the yarn to bloom and soften up in the wash whenever I did block it. So I'm very excited about this one. I'm also excited about the length. I added length to the body, as I normally have to do with all my sweaters, and I added length to the sleeves. I'm not a fan of just hitting the wrists. I have long arms, and that just makes me look like I've got a sweater that's too short, and I'm constantly tugging on my sleeves. So this is the perfect length for me, just over my thumb. And the color work, I used just Cascade 220 in a natural that I had left over, and I had just the right amount to do the color work on it. It was so fun. I enjoyed it so much. I actually, when I picked it up in the evenings, I was like, I can't wait to get this knit. But at the same time, I didn't want to go through it so really fast because I was enjoying the process so much. And that's not usually something that happens with me. So I took my time with it and I really enjoy it. Now, another thing, when Sarah was on the podcast, we had talked about, or she had talked about round yoke sweaters and how adding short rows before the color work and after the color work really helped to make the back stand up a little bit more and the front lower down, which is really what you need. So if you notice, if I turn around here, you can see how much orange stockinette is here. And then in the front, you'll notice there's none, and that's because of the short rows. So there are short rows just right here, and then just right at the neck again, and it is perfect, a perfect fit. So I'm super happy with this. I want to wear it everywhere. It's going to be worn out, I'm sure. But yeah, I'm definitely hooked on color work and bottom-up yoke sweaters. So you may see a few in the near future. So that is the first FO that I have this week. The next one, I've been trying to go through all my whips on Ravelry and seeing what... Everybody kind of goes through this at this time of year, seeing what you want to work on, if you're needed to frog it, if you're kind of out of love with your project. So I had the Cozy Memories blanket that I started, and I knew when I started it that I wasn't 100% sure that I was going to make a giant blanket out of it, but I wanted to, I enjoyed the process of knitting those little squares, and I wanted to see where it took me. So when I looked at my my whips on Ravelry, I looked at the picture of the blanket of what I had, and I decided I was done. So instead of ripping it out, we decided that if I knit a couple more squares, I could turn it into a little doll blanket. And T got a Journey doll for Christmas this year, so we decided to make her a blanket. And I think I had maybe three squares left. Let me see. I think it was up here, three squares that I had left to do to make it into a triangle, or triangle, rectangle. So I finished it off, and then what I did was I just added a fabric backing to the back of it so that you couldn't, I did weave in all the ends, but you can't see all the lines and everything on the back. Now I must say, I thought this was going to be a quick, oh, I'll just finish it and I'll add the fabric on the back and it will be done tonight. Well, when I started to pin the fabric to the knitting, it got so stretchy because of all this garter stitch. It was not easy to sew. And when I put it through my sewing machine, because you have kind of have your foot down, your presser foot down, it pulls and kind of makes it even stretchier. So I did it maybe three times, and I ended up with having more fabric left over than knit, or more knit than fabric. So it took me a while to get it done. But it's done, and it's the perfect little blanket. It actually could be a really cute pillow, too, for a bigger doll or something. But she's enjoying it. So that's my Cozy Memories, the end of the Cozy Memories. I also have another crocheted square blanket, and I'm not sure what I'm going to do with that yet, but I think I'm done with that one, too. So that's my other FO. And these are just... a lot of these ones here, these three, one, two, and three, were from my shawl that I knit very recently. And a lot of them were actually minis that were sent to me from a friend from Germany. So thank you for helping make our little dolly blanket. So those are my FOs. Now, has it been a couple of weeks now? One, maybe 2 weeks ago, I called Sarah up and said, hey, I'd like to go to Briggs. Would you like to go with me? We can scoot up there and scoot back in an hour. So Sarah said, yes, absolutely, I'll go. So we decided to take a little jaunt up to Briggs Little. So I didn't do a tour of the mill that day. We were kind of tight on time. And I honestly didn't ask if I could go take a tour. We just went into the store and I was looking for certain things, yarn wise. So that kind of took up all of our time. But I did take some pictures and some little video clips, and I'll insert them here. So have a look and we'll be right back. Little store. They don't really need anything bigger than that where they are, and a lot of their sales are online, so it's perfect for them. I did love walking in and seeing all the colors. I've never actually been able to see all the colors in person before, because that's the first time I've ever been to the mill. Briggs is sold in our Great Canadian Dollar store here, but they only have Tuffy, which is the sock yarn, and Heritage, which is like a worsted. So there were so many more colors and varieties and weights of yarn there that I had never seen before. So I did pick up some things and I wanted to show you. So first off, you'll probably notice, and I probably pointed it out, that there is a big basket in the middle of the floor when you go in, and that's the sale bin. Now if you go, they have a big sale once a year, and if you go then, you can get some really nice colors in there for a steal of a price. So I did find some yarn in there, and it's actually Cottage Craft yarn. Now Cottage Craft was a company that is no more, and Briggs spun the yarn for them. So this colorway will no longer be available, and it was, I'm just going to check my receipt, because I think it was $3 for these. Yeah, $3. So it is 1 ply, 100% pure wool, 4 ounces or 113 grams. It says 360 yards. Like, that's a crazy deal. Now, I don't know if I'm going to be able to get this color right. It's coming out brown, but it's not. It's like a, I wonder if I put it with the natural, if it would come out. It's like an olivey green, a very dark olivey green. So I did get 3 skeins. And you can see there that it is a single ply. So I got 3 skeins, so over 1,000 yards for $9. So this is like a sport weight, so this is going to make some kind of a, I'm assuming, yoked sweater, as seems to be what I'm into right now. I did get a contrasting color. Now, this can go with either of the yarns I got, so I should have actually gotten 2, but I can get it anytime. So this one is the Briggs and Little Sport. Again, it's 1 ply, and it's, again, 113 grams, which is 430 yards. So that's the beigey color, so that can either go with this one as a contrast color. And the other color, now this one I was completely in love with, and I'm excited to knit with it. It's the same sport, again, the exact same weight and yardage, and I got 3, and it's a beautiful purple. Can you see the flecks of blue in that? Let me get closer. This one's called Mulberry. Oh, there we go. How beautiful is that? See all the blue? They have the most amazing colors. Everything, you think it's just a plain purple until you look up close and you see all the different flecks of color in it. There were quite a few of these types of sport weight with all the flecks in it that I really wanted, but I know that I can go back and get more anytime, and they're not gonna discontinue it, so I'll use up what I have for now. So I'm thinking a colorwork sweater with these. How pretty would that be? And then let me see if I can get the green to come out for you. It's still coming out brown. It's a very olivey army green. Yeah. So those are my purchases. So 2 sweaters, and I mean, I think the sport weight is $6, so $18, $21 for a sweater. And this one is going to be like $9, $12 for a sweater. You can't really go wrong. And it smells so sheepy. Oh, it's yummy. So those were my purchases. I did also grab something for you guys. So I'm going to open a thread, and this is just open to anyone that would like to try Briggs, maybe that never has, or if you have and you just love it and you want to enter in, you're welcome to as well. So I got you guys some Tuffy, which is great for socks. And you may have seen, I'll post a picture here of my work socks that I've made before. So I got you a denim, just this beautiful blue. And this one is called Oatmeal. So you can pair them together, you can use them separately. And I also got you guys a little Briggs and a little pencil. So that little prize package is gonna be going up on a thread on Ravelry. If you're interested in the giveaway, just answer the prompt that I leave there for you and you guys can enter in, and good luck. So I'm definitely thinking some of that Briggs is going to be jumping onto my needles pretty soon. I just want to finish the current sweater that I've already started before I jump into that one as well. So let's talk about New Year's. New Year's is always something a lot of people are setting goals and what they're going to accomplish this year. I don't like to set goals for myself for my knitting. My knitting is fun. My crafting is fun, and I don't work well when I feel stressed and that I have deadlines for things and I have to get this done in this certain time. So I'm taking this year to just go with the flow, and whatever jumps on my needles or I decide to make is going to happen. So I've been doing, that being said, I've been doing a lot of purging and cleaning out and organizing. I did get rid of quite a few bags of things to Salvation Army a couple of weeks ago, and I've been giving some things away on the Spread Your Love thread on my podcast group, which is Celtic Cast On Podcast on Ravelry. So if you're possibly interested in something there, shoot me a message and I can get it sent off to you. But I'm just kind of trying to spread the love with things that aren't getting used. but are still in great condition. So you may see some more things pop up there as well. So I have been organizing, I have been sorting, and my crafting area, which is right over there, which is the table that you usually see behind me, is getting a revamp. So I'm excited for it. And hopefully I'll have a little video to show you maybe of it getting all organized. But right now we're gonna stick to the floor until it gets finished. So I am planning to shop from Stash this year. I have just bought some Briggs, and I can think of two other places that I may possibly buy yarn this year. One would be, I have a gift certificate to my local yarn store, so I won't be spending any money, but it would be yarn that's coming in. And also, if we do a little road trip, there is a yarn store that I'd like to go there, so that would be my only other place. I have so many sweaters I want to knit, and I have the yarn for most of them. I have so many socks that I want to knit, and I can make do with the sock yarn that I have. So this year I'm going to be using my Stash and hopefully dwindling it down a little bit to, it is a good, it's not, what's the right word? I don't have an overabundance of Stash, but I have plenty. So I'm gonna try and get it down quite a bit this year. And I know with my sweater knitting, once I get a sweater off the needles, it takes a good chunk out of the box that all my yarn is stashed in. So we'll work on that. So this year I'm going to give it a go with a box of socks. I don't care if I reach 12 socks or not, but what I have done is I bought the ornament organizer from Canadian Tire that I'm sure you've seen in other spots. They were on sale. I bought two. My plan is that I'm going to house my actual knitted socks in these when I'm not wearing them. Right now they end up getting washed and hung up on my little octopus thing, and then I pull them right off the octopus and put them back on. But in the summertime I don't really wear my knit socks a lot because I don't do anklets or anything. So I'm hoping to house them in here. I have noticed that in my my sock stash that I do have, there are a lot of socks that don't fit me right, or there's something about them that bother me. The toe is too narrow. The heels don't fit right because they're not heel flaps, which is what I enjoy. So I'm going to commit to starting to knit socks. Well, I already am. I'm knitting socks that fit me and fit my feet and are enjoyable to wear. So that's what the plan is with this. I'm just going to take yarn that I already have, and I've stashed quite a few in there already. And I'm not sticking to this. Like if I decide, ooh, there's a pair of socks I'd love to knit, I can swap it out at any time. I'm just putting some in here to give me some inspiration. But hopefully I'll have some new socks in here and new ones that I can wear and enjoy wearing. So that's the plan. That being said, let's move into whips because I have started a new pair of socks. Okay, shall we talk about socks? First off, let me talk about my bag. I participated in the bag swap by Shannon of Socksetra and the Knitting Tight podcast. This is the 2.0 version. I was in the first one and I had good success, so I decided to join again. And this time I actually was paired up with someone I was familiar with before. But now I can definitely say is my friend. So Marsh from Hey Brownberry, the Brownberry Chronicles podcast, made me this gorgeous bag, and look, it's got birds. That's the back. I love this fabric. And then the inside is yellow. Did she nail it or what? Birds and yellow? I'm sold. The construction at the bottom is kind of neat. I've never seen this before. And it's the same on the inside, too. It's like a little envelope flap. Kind of cool. So this is housing my new sock project. And let me just talk a little bit about it. Here's the pattern that I'm knitting. These are the Aztec socks, and they're by Sabine F, who is Frisbee on Ravelry. I'll put it right at the bottom so you can see. Now, Sabine actually very kindly gifted me the pattern. I saw the pattern and I was completely in love, so I sent her a message about them. And I wanted to share with you how the pattern originally came to be. It was a collaboration with a company called Ovis Etc. I'll put this all at the bottom because it's not English, so I don't want to butcher it on her. But she is Saska, and she is in Holland. Now, a lot of her yarns are, her bases are grown in Holland. She uses all lead-free dyes, and it's all non-superwash yarn, so it's all 100% wool. She does have beautiful colorways. I follow her on Instagram, and you should definitely check her out there. But she was the one who made the yarn and dyed it, especially for this project. But aren't those gorgeous socks? I love them from the get-go. So I've kind of, because I'm using Stash this year, I kind of went through and picked out some colors that I thought would go together. Now, I started this just a few nights ago, and it has been flying off the needles. Each little section is a different chart, so I just was kind of like, oh, I'll just finish this chart. Oh, I'll just start this next chart. Oh, I'll just finish this chart. And it's just been flying right off. So I've actually finished the leg, and this is what I've got so far. Isn't it beautiful? I'm so excited. So this is... the navy blue is Cascade Heritage. The green is Dale of Norway, Baby Ull, I think. That's 100% wool. So I was kind of iffy on using it for socks, but there's not, it's just in color work on the foot. It's not the main color. And then the gray is Dove Heather in Knit Pick Stroll. So I'm really loving how these are working up. And I'm actually using Addies today. These are my my Red Cable Addies, and I originally had these on the Spread the Love forum post to pass on to someone else, but I think I'm actually going to keep them. I'm not 100% sold on Addies, and these are the red cables, and they tend to, they give off of a smell when you knit with them, and they kind of tarnish and turn black a little bit, so you kind of have to keep on top of them. But that being said, they are my only 3mm sock needles, and I prefer the join to the Knit Picks one for sure. So I think I'm gonna keep these for now, and we'll see how I go with them. So 3mm for the leg. The cuff was knit on a 2.5, and I think if I were to do these again, I would go up to 2.75 because it is quite tight, especially with that ribbing. But I'm enjoying it very much, and thank you to Sabine for the pattern. And hopefully you can check her out again, Frisbee on Ravelry, and the collab with the yarn if you wanted to do it in the same colors. And you can also, I'll put in a picture of another version of it that she knit, and it was navy and yellow and gray, I think, and it's beautiful as well. That's Ovis Etc. So that's one whip. And my next whip is my other sweater that I told you that I was starting. So this one, again, I'm taking the same cue that I did from my this sweater that I just finished, my son and daughter, and I have started the sleeves. So I've got one sleeve done. And I am almost to the end of the second sleeve. I kind of put this down for a bit so I could work on socks, but if I pick it up again, I'll just fly along. So this yarn is Cascade 220. I'll have to look up the color number and insert it here because I'm not 100% sure. But this is actually yarn that I've repurposed from a cardigan that I knit that I wasn't happy with the fit anymore. I knit things too small and I just can't wear tight things anymore. So I frogged it and I'm re-knitting it into something I love. So this is, where is my pattern? This is called Northbound, and it's by This Bird Knits. Let's see if I can find her picture. So this is Northbound by This Bird Knits on Ravelry, and it's gorgeous. I'm so excited for this one. I love that blue. I wish I had that blue to knit it in. And I think when I got this pattern, for some reason, I think it was a dollar. She had some kind of a special going on where you could get one of her patterns for a dollar or something. So I got this one and I'm super excited to knit it. So that's what I'm working on. And again, Cascade 220, and I'm just gonna do it with some cream as well. I've gotta find some more cream because I know I don't have enough right here, but it's gonna be cute and hopefully as wearable as this one is. So I'm actually, one thing I should say about this, because it's frogged from another sweater, I don't know that I have enough to just do a plain body all the way up until the yoke. I think I have around 800 or something yards, and where it would be fine, but where I have to add length to the arms and to the body, it's going to be kind of iffy. So I'm thinking I'm going to take some element of the yoke and place it along the bottom of the sweater so I can add more of that cream in, and that way it might give me a little more brown to work with to make sure I have enough all the way up. So those are the whips. So now let's talk about a knit along. Before Christmas, but long ago, probably August or September, Emma of Eldenwood Craft asked me if she could send me a bag for a giveaway. Yes, birdie bag fame. So Emma sent me this gorgeous birdie bag, just like mine, except it has a red zip. It's gorgeous, absolutely gorgeous. And it's just plain white inside, and here's her beautiful tag. She does things so beautifully. So I'm going to be using this bag in our next KL. So in keeping with the theme of working from our stash, I'm going to have a use your stash KL. So if you can knit absolutely anything as long as it's from stash. And if it is a repurposed knit, I'm going to give you two entries into the draw. So this will be one of the prizes. And I also have a cute little needle holder from Maple Mousse Fibers. Little bow ties. So I'm going to be throwing this into the hat as well. So that's my friend Michelle. So two prizes so far. If you are a company at all and you would like to send some prizes or patterns or anything, absolutely give me a shout. But as of right now, these will be the two prizes for the knit along. I would love to start a thread and get some chatter going. See what you're knitting on and what your kind of ideas are and your thoughts of what yarn and maybe patterns you're going to use. So definitely use your yarn stash, your pattern stash. We all know we've got tons of patterns that we can use that we have stash on Ravelry. I know that I'm guilty of clicking purchase, or if it's a freebie, adding it to my library and then completely forgetting about it. So definitely go through your library and see what you can knit from that, and let's talk about it. So I'm going to open a thread on that. The KL will start now. Today is January 21st, so January 21st to March 31st. Perfect. So it'll give you 2 months to get lots of knitting in and have some fun together and possibly win some prizes. So that's all I have for this week. I hope you have a beautiful rest of January, of what is left of January. I'm hoping for some snow. I think we have a storm coming on Tuesday, so hopefully it will stay and there'll be no rain this time. So until next time, I guess I will talk to you soon.